Time to welcome to Whistler Tesla the gentleman we saw on film with Nazareth earlier on in the programme. Here's Dan McCafferty. Welcome to the programme, Dan.
Before we start, young man, this is for you.
Thank
That's
you very
a
much.
A pair of haggis.
Great.
No, it's actually a gaggle of haggis.
A gaggle?
Yes. I cut the legs off them before we came in because they'll run away.
Yeah, that's just what I was going to say.
And you've got to watch them. If you keep them together like that, they'll breed.
Okay, all right. Dan, since we're here in Glasgow, let's first of all talk about Glasgow, okay, and the music scene here and how you got started.
Well, we are from the other side of the country, actually. In Edinburgh, you know. But the only place you could ever get any recognition when you first started in a band was Glasgow. And we used to play the Burns House regularly, which was it's a pub, and we were one of these bands that were in between things. Like, we used to play, like, some hits. You know, you had to play a certain amount of top 10 records to actually get work, you know? And we used to play some of those and some of our own and some sort of little-known material. And we used to manage to get both gigs in the Burns House and the Electric Garden, which for Glasgow was quite a feat. Yeah. Because the Burns House was where you went when you were like 16. No, the Burns House was the one where you went when you had a bird already, and you were thinking about getting married, and you were wanting to get drunk on Saturday morning. And you used to go there and listen to music. And the Electric Garden was the one where you went before you were 16. And you were trying to pull a bird,
right.
You know, and you had to play the pops there and like what you wanted to play in the house. Mm. It's a good city though. It's got lots of different faces.
Yeah, how many bands were there around at that point, Dan?
Millions.
Yeah.
I mean, trying to get something like £8.10 on a Saturday night was a feat.
Yeah.
We used to get £6 for the Burns out on a Saturday morning.
£6?
Plus 3 pints. That was good. That was a good one.
Who were some of your contemporaries at that time?
Well, there was Alex's band. Were Tear Gas were big heroes at that time. And the Poets, some of whom are blue now. You know, but they were really into it because they were all good-looking boys and everybody fancied them, so they used to get lots of gigs. We were all ugly and up against it.
Yeah. So what's the transition? How is the transition from Glasgow to London?
Well, the thing is, like, I think Glasgow gives you a taste for fans. You know, everywhere else in Scotland is very sort of laid back and frightened to let their emotions go a bit. Well, it was then, anyway. And when you came to Glasgow, if somebody liked you, they used to shout things like, "I like him, he's great," and all that, you know. But they actually used to let you know that they liked you. And if they hated you, they used to do things like beat you up and let the van tires down and stab your roadie and things like that. But fortunately, we had big roadies at that time. It gives you a taste for, I don't know, success, I suppose. You know, that you're actually doing something that people enjoy, you know? And I think it's the only sort of cosmopolitan city in Scotland, as in London as England, you know? Mm. But the music scene in Britain is dominated by London, SNP, prick your ears up. But, you know, so we had to go to London, really, and sort of do all the club gigs and the famous marquee and stuff like that to actually get, you know, national recognition, if you like.
Yeah. Because pulling things up to date now, Dan, you're just about to start work on a solo album.
I am, yes. You?
What form will that take?
It'll be very old songs, really, and that I've always enjoyed singing in the bath and things. And just songs that I really love, but I couldn't do with Nazareth because they're not in the context of Nazareth. Mm. But it should be quite interesting, really.
Mm.
I'll be involved in that up till September. Well, up until I've got my own album. I've got my own album to do, right? And then we do an Nazareth album, and then we go to Canada because, like, that side of the world is really starting to happen for the band. And,
yeah,
you know, we're collecting sort of gold albums and things.
Yeah,
and we're going to get over that side and do a bit of work there.
What about spin-offs from your own album, though, Dan? Will you be performing on your own at any point?
Well, I think if it's in context with Nazareth, like even maybe a couple of songs that we can do, I would do it, you know?
Mm.
But the thing being that everything's really sort of happening in different ways for us at the moment. Like in Britain, it's not really that amazing, although the new single seems to be going quite well. Yeah. But the rest of the world is doing well for us.
Yeah. Well, I look forward to the album, Dan. And thanks for coming in to see us.
Enjoyed it.
Thank you. Dan McCafferty.